Today, at least 30% of a group of workers must sign cards to become part of a union. The National Labor Relations Board will then certify the cards. Once that process takes place, a majority of eligible employees must approve joining the union. The card check bill could bypass the election process by certifying unions if a majority of workers sign cards on the spot. Opponents of the proposal say employees could be intimidated into joining a union if there is not a secret ballot. Supporters point out voting can still take place in private. Unions see card check as one of the best vehicles to increase membership in years. According to the U.S. Bureau of Labor Statistics, 12.4% or 16.1 million American workers belonged to unions in 2008. That's an increase of 428,000 from the year before, but down from more than 17.5 million in 1983. The same research shows government employees are five times more likely to be represented by a union than employees in the private sector. A higher percentage of blacks hold union jobs than workers of other races or ethnic groups. In 2008, union members had a median weekly income of $886 compared to $691 for non-union workers. A vote could come up on card check this spring or summer, and President Obama supports it. For SmartTalk, I'm Scott LaMar.